Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Recombu at IFA 2016, checking out the Motorola booth. And in my hands, I have the newly unveiled Moto Z Play, and behind it, I have the latest gamut of Moto Mods. So Moto Mods are the Z family's accessory line. They're modular accessories that magnetically attach to the back of any of the Motorola Moto Z phones. So that includes this, the Z Play, but also the Moto Z, and in the US, the Moto Z Force 2. So four of the five behind me already exist, but there's a new one on the end which we'll get to in just a second. So first of all, I just want to take you through the basic premise of all these Moto Mods. So this one here is called a style shell. There's a lot of different Moto Mod style shells out there, different colors, different materials. This seems like some sort of woven material, maybe like a Kevlar perhaps. There's also wood finishes, leather, to suit your taste, to suit protection levels, and they just attach onto the back of the phones just magnetically like that. They're pretty flush, they don't add too much bulk. They also actually all remove the camera bump, so there's no camera bump if you're using a style shell. So that's a nice aspect of any of these cases, as well as just personalizing your phone that little bit more. So that's the style shell. Then we move on to the next thickest edition, which comes in black or white. This is the Incipio off-grid Moto Mod. So Incipio's off-grid line is basically a whole range of battery cases, for smartphones, but the Moto Mod version basically is designed explicitly for the Moto Z family, and as with the style shell, it just magnetically attaches on there. It's a little bit bulkier, but it adds a 2220 milliamp hour battery on top of the phone's native power. So in the case of the Moto Z Play here, that is I believe it's a 3510 milliamp hour cell, which offers 50 hours of use on a single charge, but you bolster that with an additional 2220 milliamp hours, so you've got loads of battery life to play with. If that's something that you're ever worried about, this might be the pairing for you. So that is the Incipio off-grid power case. Then we have the JBL Soundboost speaker. So this is an additional speaker. There's also a dedicated battery in there, but like the previous Moto Mods, it connects on. It's the bulkiest, well, one of the bulkiest potentially, but it adds a notable, it's got JBL's signature sound quality on there, and the built-in battery gives it an additional 10 hours of playback. And what's more, it has a kickstand. This, like some of the other Moto Mods, comes in black and white to match your phone, but you can also stand the phone up, so it's great if you want to just enjoy music, or if you want some bigger sound from your phone when you're enjoying some media like a movie or something like that. And again, this one disconnects in much the same way. And you can see there's actually the types of USB that the phone uses. You can also use to charge the Soundboost, JBL Soundboost speaker right there. So put that to one side. Then we come to the InstaShare projector, which is arguably one of the most interesting and most expensive accessories in the Moto Mods lineup. Just rearranging my table here. So the projector itself, it does have its own battery, but it doesn't need to rely on that. It can use the phone's battery completely, so even if this is dead, you can still use the projector. So the way it works is it doesn't block the camera. This polished element here, there's a bit damaged there, is actually the stand, so you can project it up there. And it uses the phone's gyroscope to add automatic keystoning. So the higher up it is or the lower down it is, it'll actually change the distortion of the image so it still appears like a perfectly squared image on the wall or on your screen. That's a really nice aspect of this. There's also a speaker in the base there, I believe that is. And then there's a power button here, and then there's a focus wheel here so you can actually focus the image too, of course. Now this projects up to a 70 inch image on a wall or screen, and the built-in battery adds a little extra time, and of course it has good brightness. It has a 50 lumen bulb, so decent brightness for a tiny pico projector such as this, and nice to have one that integrates with the phone so neatly. Now the last piece of the Moto Mod puzzle is this. This is the newest Moto Mod. Motorola and Lenovo have partnered with famed camera manufacturer and camera maker Hasselblad, who have provided the optics and some of the hardware inside this mod. So this gives you a camera grip with physical hardware controls. You've got a camera zoom there, you've got a shutter button, and you've got a power button that's there. This doesn't have its own battery, it just relies on the battery in your phone, but if I snap it on here, you can launch the camera like normal, or you can do the classic Motorola camera flick, and it recognizes the true zoom. This is the Hasselblad True Zoom, I should say, sorry. Jump through this, got it. So now we have the camera interface. So standard Motorola camera interface, nothing different there, but the camera that it's shooting with is now the Hasselblad True Zoom Moto Mod. So this is a 10 times optical zoom with a 12 megapixel sensor in there, and a Xenon flash. So it's a really impressive upgrade over the stock camera experience, which I believe in the case of the Moto Z Play is a 16 megapixel sensor, and in the Z, the standard Moto Z, a 13 megapixel sensor with optical image stabilization. Peel that off, as you do with all the Moto Mods, and that's it. Those are the latest batch of Moto Mods for the Moto Z family here at IFA 2016. If you have any questions about any of these accessories or the smartphone, you can check out coverage on recombu.com/mobile or drop us a line down below in the comments, and we'll try and get back to you. Thanks for watching. Bye.